Beppe, thank you very much for hosting us here.
As Mayor of Milano and alumnus, welcome to Palazzo Marino.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your time.
Pleasure.
So basically, you have had an impressive career, both in private and public sector. Before at Telecom Italia, then Pirelli, and then an important company in energy, A2A. But then you decided to switch to the public sector with, first of all, the Municipality of Milan as Managing Director, the CEO of Expo, an impressive success, but then Mayor of Milan. When and why did you decide to give back to the community, and what are the core differences between these two broad sectors?
Good question, but difficult to reply. Probably life decided for me. Honestly, I spent some 25 years working in the private sector. Then for some strange reason, I decided to jump to the public service. And I'm very happy, honestly. I am very happy. I know that working in the public system, it's more difficult, but it is rewarding. That in condition, following some condition, first of all, you have to love to be part of a community. You have to love to be always in touch with people. But I love that, and I love Milan.
So in 2018, you have written a beautiful book, Milan and the Century of the Cities. Can you give us in few details what is the perfect equilibrium between local autonomy and central government?
As my very famous colleague Michael Bloomberg said, this is the century of the cities, because probably a new form of society, a new form of social living will be generated in the cities. Our expectations are here. So another fundamental thing is that in a city, in an international, open and developed city, it is easier for a mayor to involve the citizen in a qualitative discussion.
Sure.
Going ahead,
sure.
And trying to find a new solution for our lives.
So few people know that Milan hosts more than 200,000 students with a population of 1.3 million, if I remember well, the city, I mean. And it's very similar to Boston in terms of ratio university students to population. So what would you like to tell to international students that decide to join one of our beautiful universities in social sciences, engineering, medicine, and other important subjects?
First of all, we have wonderful universities. But I mean, in my opinion, it is easy for an international student to live in Milan. It is not a big city.
Sure.
For instance, you cannot, you can avoid to buy a car because through the
sure.
public transportation services or car sharing, you can survive more than survive. Mm. Milan, it's in this period, a vibrant, interesting city. We know that we still have problem. Number one is houses. We do not have enough affordable houses. Our 2030 plan is based on a socio-demographic analysis, and one of the pillars is this one.
By the way, congratulations for 2026 Winter Olympics, which I think will contribute to this.
It's been a fantastic moment, a thrilling moment. I could not imagine, but at the end, when the president of IOC opened the paper, I was astonished.
University students in these days are very smart, but they seem to be a little bit confused about the political messages that range from Brexit to the trade war between China and US. What you as a politician would like to tell them?
First of all, that it is so normal that they are confused sometimes. Our message are not so clear. And the political debate, it is not so interesting. But my message is that they should follow those politicians who are in condition to work on the main transformation in our societies.
Sure.
So in our society, so we are in condition to tell their story about digital transformation, environment, climate change, social equity. We have to do that, and they have to follow and to keep informed about our action.
This is a brilliant message. Thank you so much, Beppe, for the time that you gave us.
It's a pleasure. See you in Bocconi.
Of course.